So another thing that I never thought I'd be saying, kitten heels and a green cardigan. But that's how we evolve our style, guys. Trying new things. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm just gonna jump straight in to this week's video. I felt like I really wanted to do a good old classic outfits video, and I asked you guys on my Instagram if you were still in winter mode or if you were craving some spring vibes, and the vote was overwhelmingly in favour of spring. So today I'm going to be bringing you some outfit springspiration. Almost everything I'm showing is new season, so you can buy it now, so don't forget that I'll link everything I show down below in the description box. And just to let you know, this video does contain an ad from Topshop. Praise be! I've officially peaked. I mean, where do you go from Topshop? There's nowhere to go. I've also tried to make some of these outfits somewhat appropriate for the actual weather, because although it's officially spring, it's actually freezing. So some of these outfits should transition you nicely from winter to spring. So please do get comfortable. Don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on the post notification bell if you're new here today. And yeah, let's go. So guys, this is the first look, and it's probably one of my favorites of the video. It really got me into the spring mood because I just think it's so easy and wearable and casual, but it just looks so cute and girly and chic and stylish. I just love it. So let's talk about it. First of all, I have this beautiful top. I snapped this up as soon as I saw it on Topshop New In. I was like, oh my God, I have to have that. Lilac isn't usually my color, but it is a very pinky lilac. It's very, very beautiful, very spring, like pastel ice cream colors, which of course just never goes out of style. And it has these incredible puffy sleeves. And I'm really in the mood for this because I just did a collaboration with Victor and Rolf, and they actually dressed us in like Victor and Rolf couture. And this is exactly what it's like. It's all about this like taffeta fabric, puffy sleeves, really exaggerated and over the top, but this has a really beautiful like smocked body, so it just looks really, really flattering and really stylish. It has a really beautiful ruched neckline in like a sweetheart shape, and everything about it is just gorgeous. It's so wearable, but it does make a statement, which is what I love about it. The jeans are also Topshop. These are the Jamie jeans in this really nice like off-white ecru color. I think these are such a great way to transition your wardrobe from winter to spring, because obviously they are keeping you nice and warm, but they just look so spring-like. These are probably some of my favorite jeans that I've ever tried on. As you guys know, I'm quite fussy with jeans. I really like them to be high up on the waist. I think it just gives you a really nice flattering look. It nips in your waist, it makes your legs look longer. I'll always opt for that over something that kind of sits on the hip. I just think it's so much more flattering. And these are so comfortable. They're so like stretchy. You can move in them. They don't feel like they're cutting me up. I've already been wearing them almost every day this week. These are actually a different pair because unfortunately I ruined my first pair because I spilt cream on them on pancake day. And it didn't come out in the wash. Who knew that cream stained white? Very strange. So accessory wise, first of all, I have this really cute little bag. This is actually from River Island, and I got it because it kind of gave me like Lady Dior vibes. It has that little shape, that little boxy shape with the handles. The quilting is also very Lady Dior, and of course these little charms. This is really good because you can kind of emulate that style without having to, you know, spend all that money. My shoes are these really, really cool, like dusky pink faux croc pointy slingbacks. I got these from, I think, Glamorous on ASOS. This style of shoe is really in, this pointy toe slingback. It's very kind of 90s, Spice Girl. This is a very big trend this spring. And I just loved the color, I loved the style. I thought that they were unusual, but not totally out there and unwearable. And they have a really nice heel height, just enough to give you that lift and give you that elegance and style, but they're still very, very easy to walk in, very, very comfortable. And then finally, the pièce de résistance is this beautiful pearl chain necklace. This is from And Other Stories. I just think it's beautiful. It's very eye-catching. It really adds something to this look. Normally I have a high neck, but now I have like my chest out. I feel like I want to add a nice little eye-catching accessory, and this is so, so pretty, and it will go with so many outfits. So next I have what is very much a classic Freddy outfit. This is the kind of outfit where I just feel completely myself. Like, I'm pushing no boundaries here. This is totally within my comfort zone, but it's just so cute. I can't get over it. So the jumper is adorable. I think I'm going to most certainly have to keep this because it's just divine. It's from And Other Stories. As you guys know, I love their clothes, but I especially love their knitwear. It's just always perfection. And this jumper is just gorgeous. It's a little short sleeve crop, lovely soft knit with a high neck, very, very 60s, very vintage and retro looking. And the sleeves have a beautiful little puff as well, like a really, really lovely detail. It's subtle, but it's just a really gorgeous design. And you could wear this jumper with so many different things. And the skirt is unreal. I love this skirt so much. It's from Sister Jane, which is a brand that I adore. And now you can actually shop it on ASOS. And their pieces are just amazing. They're really high quality. They're a little bit more expensive because it is an independent label. And everything they do is so retro chic and amazing. It's like an ivory tweed with pink and gold and these beautiful gold little buttons, which are just such a stunning detail. And the whole design of the skirt is honestly flawless. And I am such a skirt snob, and I'm telling you, this skirt is like the best. I'm wearing my little vintage Chanel bag with this outfit because I think the whole thing is very Chanel vibed. And obviously the boots are incredible. Unfortunately, I think these are out of stock now because I got these in November, and it's honestly such a shame. I'm gonna actually write to River Island and ask them to consider bringing these back because I get so many questions about them, so many compliments. Every single time I wear them out of the house, somebody compliments me on them and says, oh, I love your Dior boots. So I will try and find something similar online and link it for you guys. But altogether, I just love this look so much. It's such a Freddie outfit. I feel so myself in an outfit like this. And again, I think this is a really good winter to spring transitional outfit because you have the warmth of the knit. The skirt is actually quite a wintry skirt. It's very, very thick fabric. So with a little like jacket over the top or a coat, you'd be good to go. So next up, another jeans outfit. I'm clearly getting into jeans at the moment. And these are also from Topshop. These are the mum jeans, again in that off-white ecru colour, which I really like. And I also really love these jeans. I can't decide if I prefer these or the Jamie jeans. I just really, really like the fit. Again, just like the others, they're very high-waisted, which I really like. They're nice and fitted around the waist, but these are not skinny, but they are a little bit looser around the leg, which I just think is really flattering. And it just looks really, really cool. And then again, they do come in at the ankle, so they're not like flared out. I love this top, which is also from Topshop. I really like the off-white color. I think it does go really well with the jeans. And I love like the boxy square neckline and the shirred fabric. It's just very, very flattering. It makes you look very small around your waist. And it's just very comfy and cute and casual, but kind of sexy at the same time, which I really, really like. To add a little bit of something to what is quite a plain casual outfit, I got this scarf from H&M, which I love. It's so pretty. The pattern on it is gorgeous. It's like a very opulent pattern with gold and orange and pink. It's very striking. The fabric is really nice. It's very shiny satin, so it looks a lot more expensive than it actually was. I've got my Senrev Mini Maestra bag, which I love. This is such a good bag, and I love how casual it is because it's kind of like a satchel style. You can wear it as a backpack, you can crossbody, or you can just hold it like this. The color goes really nicely because it ties in with the pink in the scarf, and it just adds to that really casual everyday spring look. And then the shoes are a bit of a thing, okay? These are very much like a trend shoe. These are everywhere. They've just like sprung up out of nowhere on all stores. Like all brands are doing this like super 90s Spice Girl shoe, and I'm not entirely sure how I feel about it because they are kitten heels. Can't believe I'm saying that on my channel because I never thought I would. But they're everywhere, and the more you see it, the more you kind of become used to it, and you may even begin to like it. So it's the really low stiletto kitten heel with like the spaghetti straps, which is just such a 90s thing that I remember seeing on the Spice Girls, on supermodels of the time, like on Kate Moss. She would wear shoes like this, and they are making such a comeback. And I do think they're cool. Like, you can't deny it. They do look cool, and they're really, really nice to walk in. They're so comfortable because it's such a low heel, but it does just give you that added little style that you don't really get from wearing flats or trainers. These ones are from River Island, and I think they're a really good choice if you are wanting to invest in this trend because they are affordable, so you're not going to splash out too much money. Also, they're a really great nude colour. They'd go with absolutely any outfit, so they'd be a really good pair to start off with. And these ones have a really nice little gold stud detail around the sole sole as well, which is a very nice touch. I also just wanted to show you a couple of cardigans with this look because, again, this is a big trend. It was a big trend for autumn winter, but I do think it transitions really well into spring when you are wearing an outfit like this. So this one is from Warehouse. It's really cute, and as you can see, definitely a new color for me. This is in a pistachio color, which is a very big color trend for this year, and especially for spring, because it's pastel, it's really, really pretty, and I never ever thought that I would wear something green, but I do kind of like it. It reminds me of lingerie, so that makes it okay. And I actually really like this cardi. I like the cropped boxy fit. I think it's really cute. I just really love the whole color combination of this outfit, the pink, the green, like those ice cream shades. I just think it's adorable. So another thing that I never thought I'd be saying, kitten heels and a green cardigan, but that's how we evolve our style, guys. Trying new things. And then this is the other cardigan. This is from Topshop. I really, really like this as well. I think it's such a gorgeous winter to spring look. This is another like creamy off-white cardigan, and it's really like flimsy and holey. If that makes sense, it's not like a structured knit. It's very baggy and loose and relaxed. It's also cropped, and I like kind of if you pull it up a bit and you can see that stomach, it just gives a really like sexy casual look, which I really like. And I think with the scarf added to it, it just looks really, really nice. And I just think it's really, really cool. And it's very soft and cozy. And you know me, I love anything cozy. So next up, I have this outfit, which is a little bit different for me, especially in terms of the trousers, but I think it's very cool, very chic and feminine, and a really good transitional winter to spring outfit. So first of all, please ignore the fact that the shoes are still attached. I just haven't 100% decided if I want to keep these. I'm just trying them out, but I do really like them. They're from H&M, and they're like a kind of pointy toe, but it's not a really harsh point. It's quite a round point, if that makes sense, court shoe, and they're in this really nice like faux croc with a really lovely block heel. This style of shoe is very much on trend for spring, but I think they'll actually be a really good shoe because they're very versatile, and the color, you can obviously wear them with anything. So the trousers are from River Island. I really love the color. It's like a pale camely beige, and the style is really nice. They kind of have a tailored look around the waist. It's very fitted around the waist, but then it kind of has a looser fit around the leg. So then the top I'm wearing, I really, really, really like this. I like this actually way more than I thought I would when I ordered it. It's also from River Island, and it's a little crochet jumper top thing. It's so, so pretty. It's actual crochet flowers all over it, and it didn't come with anything underneath, so you do actually need to wear a little top underneath, and I just love this. Again, it's the perfect winter to spring piece because it is knitted, so it is quite warm even though it's sheer, but it just has that beautiful spring element with the flowers and the white. And for my bag, I've got my Dolce & Gabbana Sicily bag because I felt like it kind of added to that professional, you mean business look, but it's still very feminine and pretty. So next up, I have this outfit, which I love so much. It's so pretty, and would you believe that this dress is just River Island? It looks so Zimmerman. This dress is literally going to fly off the shelves, or the virtual shelves. It's gonna be so popular. It's so, so stunning. It's so boho. It looks really, really premium. It has such beautiful detail, like the sleeves are shirred at the wrist, and then they have a really loose fit. The buttons going down, obviously the crochet. It's just absolutely gorgeous. Obviously this look is very spring. I don't think it's the best transitional outfit, although you could swap out these shoes for some boots, but I didn't really have any that I was really happy to pair with this outfit, but maybe like some knee-high or over-the-knee brown boots would look so, so nice with this as well and make it a little bit more appropriate for colder weather. But for the moment, I just have my Tory Burch shoes that JJ got me for Christmas. The belt I'm really sad about because I just ordered this from Farfetch. It's a Chloe belt, which I thought would go so nicely with this and like so many other spring pieces, and also autumn winter for that matter, like a really good wardrobe staple. But it's a little bit big. I definitely need to size down because it doesn't have that many holes to fasten. It only has two options. But aside from that, I think it looks really good with the dress and makes it look even more expensive. I mean, it totally looks like a Zimmerman dress. It's pretty much a dupe, which is amazing. And I just think the whole look is so cute. And to top it off, I have the most gorgeous bag. I actually got this from Farfetch for my trip to Marrakesh. and I just fell in love with it. It's from C by Chloe, which is Chloe's like more affordable line, although it's still really, really expensive. But to put it into perspective, the Chloe Drew is like £1,000. This is like £300. So although it's very expensive, there is still a big gap between Chloe and C by Chloe, but it still has that beautiful feminine boho style, which we love. And you can actually just hold it over your elbow like this. You can even wear it up here, which I think is really cute. But then it also does have a long strap if you want to wear it crossbody. It's just such a good spring summer bag, and I think it goes so nicely with the whole look. And like I said, if you do want to make this a little bit more wearable for the current temperatures, pop it with some brown boots and maybe a nice like trench coat. Next, another outfit that is very Freddy. We should actually make that a hashtag, very Freddy. Like, you guys often tag me in posts of your outfits when it was inspired by me, but you should hashtag very Freddy. It could be like my tagline. It could actually be the name of my clothing line. How cool would that be? Very Freddy. Like, that's very, like, that outfit's very Freddy. And then make that. So it's pretty similar to the other outfit, but in a different colorway. I don't often do blue, but when I do blue, I very much like it. And I really, really like this skirt. It's from And Other Stories, and the quality is so nice. And it's a really simple pale blue tweed skirt, really nice for spring, but it transitions really, really well because of course you can pair it with knitwear like I have today. This jumper is River Island, and it is so nice. When I took it out of the bag, I was really surprised at how premium and luxurious it felt. It's just really, really nice quality. It's very thick, it's very soft, and it has the most beautiful pearl embellishment on the neckline, which is so, so pretty, and it just goes with the whole like Chanel vibes. I just love it. And then to go with the pearls on the neckline, I picked up this bag from And Other Stories. It's their classic pearl tote bag. Lots of brands have tried to do the pearl bag thing, but this is one of the nicest I've ever seen. The straps are so thick. It's really roomy, and it has a little like lining bag inside as well to keep your things actually safe. And then I had no choice but to put the white boots on again with this. I wanted to try something different, but I just thought, what's the point? Because this is the way that it looks the best. So I'm gonna try my best to find something similar for you guys, and I'm gonna try my best to convince River Island that they need to bring them back. I think this whole outfit is very adorable. It's very themed, but I do think that it is wearable. I think if you wanted to tone it down in the slightest, maybe ditch the pearl bag and just go for an ordinary handbag. But on the whole, I think this is such a stylish, chic, wearable outfit that's perfect to transition you from winter to spring. So guys, this is the final outfit, and I adore this dress. It's so, so beautiful. It's from the brand Forever New, which is an Australian brand that you can shop on ASOS, and I have found so many beautiful things from Forever New, and so many of my Australian followers have said to me, Freddie, you have to check out Forever New. I've obviously paired this with some really pretty nude ankle strap heels, but you could go for ankle boots, you could even go for knee-high boots or over-the-knee boots to be totally covered, and then just a nice warm coat. Or you can wear it like this for a warmer spring day. It's just so pretty. I love the pattern, the floral pattern, but also the colours. It's very antique looking. And the dress is a bit chiffon-y, so again, it adds to that like rustic antique look, which I think is really, really beautiful. It's very like rosy colored, like rosy beige and brown, which are my colors. It's just the most beautiful dress. I can't get over it. It's swishy. You could dress this up, you could dress it down more casually with some boots and a handbag, or wear it with some heels and a little crossbody like evening bag. You could wear it to a wedding. I think it's almost quite wintry as well. Like, it's going to go really well across the seasons. Basically, I think that this would be money well spent and money justified, because it really is beautiful and quite unusual as well. I feel like I always bring this bag out when I do an outfit video, always makes an appearance, but the Mulberry Bayswater is just such a classic, and this colour, it just goes with everything, especially this dress. It ties in so well. It's a beautiful rosy beige. It really kind of dresses down this dress, which is quite, it is quite dressy, I'm not gonna lie, but this bag, which is very much an everyday bag, kind of neutralizes it and makes it look like a very like casual but chic outfit. I just love this dress so much. I just don't know what to do with myself. So guys, that's the end of the video. I really hope you enjoyed it and you got your dose of Springspiration for now. Don't forget, there will be my annual spring haul week coming very, very soon on my channel. So do make sure you are subscribed and you have post notifications turned on so you definitely do not miss it. Thank you so, so much for watching, and I will see you guys next week. Bye.